Good morning, guys, and welcome to this week's vlog. I'm going to be showing you guys my week of workouts, but it's going to be super exciting because I am going to be using my own gym guide that I created to show you guys my week of workouts. I've been wanting to do this for so long. I just don't know why I put it off, but it is kind of just like an ebook that you can purchase for very, very, very cheap over on my website. I will link everything down below. I will put all the information down below. But if you've ever wondered how I work out, you're a beginner in the gym, you don't know what to do, and you just need a very simple ebook to get you into the gym, to give you a program, this is the perfect one to start with. It's a 9-week gym guide. So it is broken down to 3 phases of 3 weeks. It periodically gets more advanced as you work through the guide. But in the beginning, it starts with the basic movements and it is very resistance heavy. And so hence the name, which is Limitless Shed and Build. So you are shedding fat, but also the program is designed to really build muscle, especially in, you know, the areas that you want to, whether that is back, glutes, all of that. So I am going to take you through this week's workout using my own guide because I literally created that based on how I work out. I am also, another thing is this week I am going to wake up at 7:30. I mean, I'm gonna be at the gym by 7:30 this whole week. So today's Monday, which is Thanksgiving Monday. It's a holiday here, so the gym opened at 8 a.m. So which is why I'm here a little bit later. But that being said, I'm excited to go in. Let's actually look on my phone at which workout we're going to do. I will give you a sneak peek of it. Oh my God, you can't even see it. Let's go through and see which one I'm gonna do. And I'm actually gonna go into phase 2 and start with a quad day. I'm gonna start with this one right here. The gym guide, like I said, is a really good representation of how I love to work out, how I first got into working out. So I think it's going to be filled with a lot of value. There's a lot of educational value in the beginning to teach you, you know, how to meal track, how to even, you know, read workouts, what are sets, what are reps, what does tempo mean, all of that. So even if, you know, you are super new, this is perfect because I will go through all the terminology, I will go through like everything in the beginning, and trust me, this is a 100-page book. There's a lot of value. But before I continue to ramble on, let's go to the gym and hit quads for day 1 of my phase 2 workout. Okay, bye, ciao. So here I am in my voiceover to run you guys through today's workout. I started off with some dynamic warm-up. The great thing about the guide is that it will run you through the warm-up and the cool-down for every single day. I'm really focusing here on trying to open up my hips because it is a lower body day and I need to do this before squatting so that I can get the depth and the range of motion that I want. The very first exercise laid out in the quad day was barbell squats. It does say 3 sets of 10 on the program, but I did 3 sets of 6 because I wanted to go extra heavy and it fit better with where I am in my strength phase. The tempo here is 3-0-X-1, which means you're going to try to take 3 seconds to go down. You're not going to hold at the bottom. You're going to stand up as fast as possible and you're going to hold at the top for a second before you go into your second rep. I try to be really mindful here. Again, it is a lot harder than you think, especially when you go heavy, but I tried my best and that's what I asked for you guys as well. So I did 3 sets of 6 before moving on to my second exercise, which here was Smith Machine reverse lunges. These are an absolute killer and so good for the quads. You're gonna start by placing one leg in front. You're gonna do one side at a time. Start with your weaker side and then work to doing your stronger side. I did 3 sets of 10 on each side. I tried to focus on the tempo, which is 2-0-X-0. However, I think I went down a little bit too fast. That being said, this is an absolute killer. It left my glutes sore for days, so I highly recommend doing this one. If this is too challenging, you can always do dumbbell reverse lunges. Then we are moving into our very first superset, which is heel elevator goblet squats. These target the quads like no other. I did 3 sets of 12 before moving on to dumbbell step ups. This is one of my absolute favorites. It's so important for just overall functionality. I did 3 sets of 10 on each side. I'm holding just the dumbbell in one hand. I think I'm holding a 30-pound dumbbell. However, you can hold two, one in each hand to make it a little bit more balanced. I find it more challenging when I hold it in one hand because there is an aspect and component of unbalance, but that helps me engage my core even more.
The key to feeling step ups in your glutes is to keep a forward lean. Notice how I'm staying over that leg that's on the bench the entire time. Then to end off the workout here, it is our very last superset. I did the leg press machine. I don't usually do this, so it's really nice to push myself to actually do this. I did 3 sets of 12, making sure that you are not locking out your knees at the top. You're inhaling on your way down, exhaling on your way up. And then this is the killer of today's workout. It is a 60 second wall sit. You are supersetting this with your leg press, so make sure you go straight into it. You can tell that I'm going through every single motion here. The 60 seconds feels super long, but I really do challenge you to try to hold it. And then my legs felt like absolute rocks, so I had to foam roll. I spent about 5 minutes foam rolling rather than static stretching, so I can really just ease my quads and my lower body. But that was today's workout. I had a great, great time, and I hope you enjoy it as well.
I didn't get a chance to recap on my workout because I had to come home and rush into a quick call, but guys, that was a fire workout. I'm not even just saying this because it was my workout, but I just loved it. I had such a good time. I loved just having everything outlined on my phone. Like, I didn't need to think about what am I gonna do next. I had everything laid out, the sets, the reps, so it made it so easy just to go in and out. That whole workout took me less than an hour 15. That's it for today's workout. I will see you tomorrow for day two of my workout guide. I will see you tomorrow at 7:30 a.m. for a second workout. Ciao.
Hi friends, happy Tuesday. Today we are doing a push day. I actually did an evening workout because I was in the gym for some clients, but I'm warming up on the bike for about 5 to 10 minutes, then I move into my upper body warm up. Again, the guide will take you through all of these warm ups. The very first exercise here is bench press. I did 3 sets of 6. I'm warming up with just the bar. Then I made sure I did around 2 warm up sets before getting into my working set of about 75 pounds, I believe. But with this, make sure you are inhaling on your way down, exhaling on your way up. I like to keep a slight arch in my back so I can get more push. However, feel free to just do it with a flat back as well if you feel that that is more comfortable. Then I moved into a superset. I did seated shoulder press. We are doing 3 sets of 12 reps. So do make sure that you're going a little bit lighter than usual. You want to try to focus on going nice and slow on the way down and exhaling on your way up. Then you're supersetting that with single arm lateral raise. I always start with my weaker arm, so that is my left side, and then working my way to my right side. So I did 10 reps on each side. Keep that core squeezed so that you are minimizing momentum as much as possible. Again, exhale on your way up. The second superset you're going to work through is chest fly machine in push-ups. I didn't have a chest fly machine at this gym, so instead I did cable flies. With this one, keep your back neutral. You're going to exhale as you bring the cables together. You can either stand in a staggered stance with your right leg in front, or here I'm just having my both leg together, slight bend in my knees. Keep that core nice and tight. Then I moved into push-ups. If you can't do regular push-ups, feel free to do kneeling push-ups or even incline push-ups. You are doing 12 reps. Have your hands a little bit wider, that way you can target your chest more than your triceps. Then the very last superset is really targeting your triceps in all way possible. You are starting off with single arm dumbbell tricep kickbacks. You're doing 12 reps on each side. Again, start with that weaker side. Then you're going straight into cable tricep extensions. You're doing 3 sets of 12. Make sure that with the superset, you are going one right after the other. That way you're not giving your triceps a bit of a break, and you will really feel that tricep bump by the end of your third set. I'm back home. I'm just about to jump in the shower, but before I do, I want to quickly give a recap of today's workout. So I did phase 2, day 2 push day. I really had a great time. It took me around an hour, and that was including the warm up and everything. So to me, perfect amount of time. I was in and out. It is around 9 p.m. So I'm gonna jump in the shower and call it a night. I will see you tomorrow. Bye. Good morning, happy Thursday. We are back in the gym for a 7:30 morning workout. We are hitting glutes and hamstrings, probably my favorite day of the week. Of course, we're starting off with heavy hip thrusts. We're trying to hit 3 sets of 10. I didn't show you guys my warm-up sets, but I did about two to three sets of warm-up before making my way up to this new PR. Make sure that you are exhaling on your way up, squeeze at the top for a second, and then bring it down slowly before going into your next rep. That's how you're gonna keep your glutes under tension and really activate your hamstrings and glutes throughout this whole rep. What I like to do is I like to hold the last rep for a few seconds before resting. Then we are moving into barbell Romanian deadlifts. I'm using wrist straps here because I find that my hands just cannot take the weight. This really helps me to progressive overload on my glutes. We are doing 3 sets of 10. We are following a tempo of 2-0-X-1, which means we are taking 2 seconds to go down. We are not holding at the bottom. We are trying to lift the weight up as fast as possible. Squeeze that glute at the top for a second, and then go in for your second rep. Then we are moving into our very first superset. We are doing dumbbell sumo squats. I like to keep a forward lean so I can feel it in my glutes more. Notice how my back is nice and neutral. And I recommend don't stand up fully at the top so you can keep constant tension in your glutes. Then we are moving into standing plate abductors. We are doing 15 on each side. You want to make sure that you are placing that weight right against your leg. Don't try to hold it. Keep your chest up and body straight and exhale as you bring the weight up. Then the very last exercise here to really burn out the glutes is your back extension. So we are doing glute focused back extension where you're gonna round everything in, tuck your chin in. I'm hugging a 25 pound plate. You're gonna exhale as you lift, but the key here is that you're gonna hold at the top for about 2 to 3 seconds before lowering your chest back to starting position. Make sure that you find a height where you can fully fold right over the platform. And that concludes our third workout for the week.
Good morning, happy Thursday. I just got done my glute day, my glutes and hamstring day. It was a little bit longer. It took me a little over an hour, like an hour and 15 minutes. But that's expected for hip thrusts, especially when you're going heavy. I don't know if it's a PR, but I did 3 sets of 10 at 265. I don't know, that is a PR. I've never done that heavy for that many reps, so that was really good, but that just meant it required that much more rest. So I was in there a little bit longer, but that's why I like morning workouts, because I don't feel like I'm in too much of a rush. However, I do need to get home, feed Rono, feed myself. Lots of protein, lots of carbs after that workout. I'm so happy I got that over with, because I love leg days, but especially glutes and hamstrings, I kind of dread it just because I know it's going to be tough. And especially if I push it off for later in the day, I'm probably not gonna go when I've just worked 5 hours and I'm exhausted. Also, the reason why I'm filming on my phone was because I packed my camera, I even packed an extra battery, but I forgot that I took my SD card out for to move the files into my computer to start editing this video. And I guess I never put it back in my camera. So I was like filming, like I tried to film and then there was no memory card. Let's go home, let's eat breakfast and get on with the day.
Hi friends, happy Saturday and welcome to our last and final workout of the week, which is our pull day. My friend actually came to the gym with me today, so it was really nice to work out with someone but also have someone to help me film. So you'll find that some of these angles are a lot better than the other days. However, I start all of my pull days with sumo deadlifts. I did about 2 to 3 warm-up sets just to see how I felt. I felt pretty good, so I went up to 2 plates, which is 225 pounds, and I hit this for about 2 sets of 3 to 4 reps, depending on how many I could get up really. But I was really proud of myself because I haven't done deadlifts in a while, and the fact that I could do 225 still was pretty impressive, so it was a great start to my workout. Then I felt like I still wanted to deadlift a little bit more, so I did 1 set of 15 reps at 135, which is a plate on each side, and I just really focused on my form here. Then moved into lat pull downs. We did 3 sets of 10 reps here. I went pretty heavy, and after deadlift, this was a killer. My forearms are burning by the end, and so are my hands, which is why you see my face here. Then we're moving into our superset. I did single arm bent over rows. I did 12 reps on each side, starting off with my weaker side. Then we went straight into alternating hammer curls. I ideally usually do 15 pounds, but they were all out, so I am doing 20 pounds here. It was rough and it was tough.
My arm is like shaking.
Girl, look at my veins here. Okay. And then I moved into our very last superset, which is cable face pulls. Make sure you are keeping that core tight. That way you are not letting the cable dictate your movement. Exhale as you pull the weights up. Keep your elbows high and think about pulling the heads to your ear. Then I lowered the cable to the very bottom so that we can do cable bicep curls. With the cable bicep curl using the rope, make sure that your elbows are tucked into your side and focus on bringing the heads here to your shoulders and break your wrist outwards a little bit. Then here I am showing off my bicep pump because they were pumped by the end of this workout. I hope you enjoy.
If you guys made it to the end of the video, thank you guys so much. I appreciate each and every one of you. I hope this video gave you a really good insight into how I work out in a week. Like I said, a lot of the workouts are taken from my new 9-week gym guide that I've been talking about all throughout this video. It is available to shop over on my website, which I will link right here, but also I'll put everything in the description box. That way it's super easy for you. I know phase 2 of the gym guide is a 5-day split. The last workout that I did not do is a cardio and core. That is because I'm usually playing volleyball twice a week, so that kind of counts as my cardio, and then I just integrate core whenever I can. That being said, I find that 4 times a week is just a really good sweet spot for me. Anything more is just too much, and I can tell my muscles that I'm very exhausted, and then anything less is little. So 4 is perfect. The great thing about this gym guide is that it provides you with so much knowledge that you can just take and apply into what you're already doing. That way it doesn't feel like you are stretching yourself too thin. The first 50 to 60 pages is just providing you with knowledge on mastering your nutrition, mastering your mindset, mastering your training, so that you really get all the tools you need to succeed in the long term and make sustainable, healthy changes. So that is why I love this guide. I'm super proud of it, and I hope you guys love it as much as I do. So if you do shop it or try out any of the workouts, make sure you tag me on Instagram. I will leave it right here at @fitness_joe. That way I can restory it and share it. But aside from that, I love you guys so much. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you guys next week for a brand new video. Bye.